be looking at generating and parsing fillable forms in Field Service using PDFLib. To start, we'll go over the field names you input onto the PDF. In your Salesforce org, it is best to add a custom field to content version object that allows you to specify the report type, this example being fire pump. With that, for our example PDF, this first page has company information that's pulled from a work order. It also contains this hidden field right here. This determines whether the page is an asset form that should be duplicated or not. This first page will actually not be duplicated in our example. Here on page 2, we have another one of the hidden flag fields. This page will actually be duplicated in our example. It contains some checkboxes and some radio buttons. With naming your fields, the naming convention will be the same for each different field type, with the exception being with checkboxes, just being slightly different. Here we go. The name starts with your custom object made specifically for this report type, this example being fire pump, then followed by the custom field name on the object for that specific field, this one being certifications. After that, it will say asset ID and then be followed by the field type, which this one is checkbox. Because this is a checkbox, we add the value of the checkbox at the end of the name, this one being red. With our radio button, the name is very similar, but it doesn't need a value input at the end. That will hold true for any other field type that is in a checkbox. Once you have updated the names of all of your fillable fields, you'll upload them to your files in Salesforce. Now that we've uploaded our PDF to Salesforce, I'm going to show you the code for how to generate the PDF. It first grabs the pages, the acro form, the acro fields, and the page annotations. It then loops through the annotations, grabs the field names by using fieldname.value, and manipulates the value from there. After that, if the added page is less than 1, it replaces the asset ID with the asset inspection ID. If it's greater than 1, meaning we're adding more than one copy page, we grab the first asset inspection ID and replace it with the new asset inspection ID. Below that, it sets the PDF name of T to our updated field name and adds it to the acro field object. And right here at PDF Bytes, this is where the actual generation of the PDF happens. Moving on, we are now going to look at what it looks like in Salesforce. For this example, I've already created a work order. I have added a few details into this section, like adding a location and a contact, just so our inspection form's first page actually is populated. And I've also made just a few work order assets from fire pump 1, 2, and 3. Because I had already uploaded my PDF into the files section of Salesforce, I'm gonna go ahead and generate asset inspection form. May take a second to load. Okay, now that it says success, I'm going to go ahead and refresh the page. And under here in the files section of the work order, we now have our generated asset inspection form. Okay, I am now going to pull up our generated PDF. This first page is the company information page and should only show up once. Because I had 3 work order assets, there should be 3 pages that contains our checkboxes and our radio buttons. Got 1, 2, and 3. Now that I've double checked and all of the PDF looks good, I'm gonna go ahead and download the PDF. Once your PDF is downloaded, you can upload it into any PDF reader you choose. Just make sure that you're able to fill the form out in that reader. All right, we'll go ahead and go into our PDF reader. The first page should already be filled out with the information from the work order. The next 3 pages should all be fillable, and I'm going to go ahead and fill these pages out. Just do red and yes. Yellow and no. And then green and NA. And once you're done filling out your form, you'll go ahead and save it. And after saving it, we're going to go ahead and upload it back into Salesforce. To upload the filled form into Salesforce, we go back to our work order page and we'll click Upload Inspection Document. We'll hit Upload Files, upload our filled form, hit Done, and Finish, and wait for the success message. Okay. Now that it's successfully uploaded, I'm going to go ahead and enter one of the work order assets, go to its related list, click on this fire pump asset inspection name, and just make sure that certifications and authority are filled out and with the answers I chose, which I did choose red and yes. Now that everything has uploaded successfully, I'm going to show you a bit of our error handling. I'm going to go ahead and go to work order. I am going to click on any of the two work orders that's not the same as the one I generated the original PDF from. We're going to hit Upload Inspection Document, Upload File, and I'm going to re-upload the fillable form I just uploaded into the correct work order. We'll hit Finish. And this throws an error basically saying I can't upload this form to a different work order than the one it was generated from. This eliminates accidentally uploading a form to a work order that would contain different information. And finally, I'm going to show you how we parse through the different field types in our PDF generator. We start with an if-else statement, grab the field name value, and loop through if it's a checkbox, option list, all of the different field types accepted in PDFLib. And for each field type, we go ahead and extract the value if it's that field type. Then parses through each one of the field types and just grabs all of that information. And that's it. The ability to automate the generation and parsing of your service reports will eliminate user error during data entry, and it'll give your users more time during their day to focus on other important tasks. This makes PDFLib a very valuable and powerful tool for any organization using Salesforce Field Service. If you're looking to add generating and parsing fillable forms to your system, contact DB Services and we'll be happy to help. Thank you.